For the past several years, Bon Appetit magazine has predicted the hot food trends of the year. For 2009, they picked New Southern to be the cuisine of the year, and the dish of the year was anything with an egg on top. Here with predictions for 2010 is Andrew Knowlton, restaurant editor of Bon Appetit magazine. Good morning. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you, Harry.
Terrific. We love segments like this. We want to see what's new, what's interesting, what's trendy. And what's this to start?
By the way, before, we were right about Southern last year. Southern foods everywhere, fried chicken, grits, eggs on top of everything.
Eggs were kind of everywhere.
Everywhere. And fried chicken, especially in New York City,
took off like crazy.
This year, though, the dish of the year is meatballs in all its different forms. Not grandma's meatballs.
Right.
But we have from Vietnam, we have from the Middle East, we have a kofta meatball, which is made with lamb.
Mm.
We have a classic pasta alla matriani,
right,
from just north of Rome.
Right.
And this one's the big one. This is the banh mi, which is a kind of a hybrid French-Vietnamese sandwich made with pork meatballs, kind of spicy. This is going to be the big thing.
Peppers on it?
Peppers, yeah. It's very nice. I mean, you've got the baguette, the mayonnaise, and then you get the cilantro from Vietnam. So this, I think, is going to be meatballs, yes, but also the banh mi sandwich.
Yeah, if it were not for the fact that this thing has been sitting here for about a half an hour, I'd be jamming on that now, because that looks so good.
Still delicious.
Yeah, all right, what are these guys?
So now we have, this is our cuisine of the year, so we're going New Austrian.
New Austrian.
Right. So basically what this comes out of, I think, is the artisanal beer boom in America.
Yeah.
Going along with that. So you have stuff like homemade pretzels.
Look at these
places
guys.
Like Prime Meats in Brooklyn that does that. You've got, I think, what's going to be the new macaroni and cheese, which is, I know something you're familiar with, spetzel.
Yeah. Love spetzel. I'm
delicious.
Crazy for spetzel.
Delicious and easy to make as
right.
well.
Yeah.
So I think it's not that you're going to see new Austrian restaurants on your corner or anything, but you're going to see influences mm-hmm. of pretzels and these ingredients. You've seen spetzel you know, at your diners and stuff. So I think that's going to happen. And obviously the beer is going to be taking off as well.
I was at a restaurant the other day that had all these amazing Italian beers.
Yes.
There was a whole page of just, and the beers were phenomenal and tiny little micro breweries.
That's what's happening across the board, and especially with countries that don't have a brewing tradition. There's no rules anymore, like in the U.S. and all that.
There you go.
So this is probably my favorite. This is the ingredient of the year. Usually it's not a processed food, but this is sriracha, which is, you'll find this in every professional kitchen. They use it at staff meal. I use it on eggs.
Yeah.
It's basically a hot sauce, chili pepper, also called, you can see the rooster on here, called rooster sauce.
Right.
And you think it comes from abroad. It's actually from Rosemead, California. A Vietnamese immigrant started this company, and now you'll see it. I mean, I predict this is going to be next to the ketchup and the mustard.
Well, that's what it says. Made and for use on soup, sauces, pasta, pizza, hot dogs, hamburgers, chow mein, anything.
Except, I'd say chocolate cake. I've tried it on that, and it doesn't
really work.
No, it doesn't work. Pretty good.
Do you know what's in this?
It's jalapenos and secret ingredients. It's very acidic, and it's spicy. But it's not just hot sauce.
Like it a lot. All right, what do we have here?
This is... Our party of the year was vegetarian cooking. And 10 years ago, if you had had, you know, a vegetarian party, you probably had two people come over to your house.
How much tofu can you celebrate?
Exactly. But now that people are cooking seasonally, we've got polenta with fresh tomato sauce. And these are sunchokes.
Yeah? They good?
Also known as Jerusalem artichokes that are just deep fried. Nice.
Oh, that's really good. All right, last but not least.
Well, obviously, comfort food. This is a comfort dessert. So we've got all these kind of old school American, this is called a slump, kind of what you're doing right now, slumping. Because it doesn't have any kind of, just sits on the plate. Delicious. So this is a brown Betty, apple brown Betty.
Right.
And this is a coconut cake.
So there's some sort of a fruit, like a compote something is baked over the top?
Yeah, it's usually...
It's almost like a biscuit.
Yeah, it's like cobblers and buckles and all these fun-sounding things. It's basically stewed fruit with some sort of biscuit on top. Quick, easy, and delicious.
Homey. And what kind of cake is that?
This is it's a riff on a coffee coconut cake. So it's got coconut, a little bit of chocolate chunk, and a little bit of lemon. So it's very refreshing.
So this is
I'm going to give you a bottle of that.
Rooster sauce.
You got to use that.
Sriracha. Andrew Knowlton, thank you so much.
Happy New Year to you, pal.
And we'll keep track and see if these things come true
next
year. For all these great food ideas, all you need to do is go to our website. That's earlyshow.cbsnews.com.